Hello, everybody. It is Monday. Welcome to a new week. And I am back with a new week in review on my blog. Just in case you guys didn't know, I always include a lot more on my blog, along with the latest day in the life blog as well. Blog, it all sounds the same, doesn't it? With my weekly to-do. So if you haven't checked it out yet, it is live on kjaggers.com. And I'd love it if you guys visited. So I just got Zane's bike ready, and he took off on a bike ride. We need to get two of our bikes serviced. I would have went with him, but we don't have two working bikes right now. But he's out riding, and it's such a beautiful day here. I got my nails painted, and that was another reason I really couldn't go. But I'm just kind of enjoying this pretty day. Cooper's enjoying it. Our neighbor across the street over here, he has a pod in his driveway, but they broke the tree, and he's like a very particular kind of person. When he gets home from work tonight, he is not going to be a happy camper about that. Not even a little bit. And I'm not even sure it's his tree. It could be the neighbor's, but I think it's his. But he's moving, and that house is sold, so hopefully we'll get some new neighbors. Cooper's out enjoying this pretty weather. We had a walk this morning, and I just went with black. I don't know why, because it's dark, and I need to actually go get some fingernail polish. I used the rest of mine up. But yeah, it's a beautiful day, and I'm very excited about the weather, and yeah, we'll get walking Cooper this evening sometime. Who's back? There he is. Woohoo! I love it that he's going out a little bit more. Cooper's happy too. I also got Zane's blankets washed today, and I hung them outside. I am super happy that I'm using less electricity, and the sunshine is drying everything, and now he can take these upstairs and make his bed. So lunch today is leftovers from last night. This is the wheat pasta with brown butter. It's so good. And I'm skipping the bread because I really don't need the bread. The pasta is enough. And yeah, I'm going to have some lemonade, and that is my lunch today. So it's Wednesday night. Everybody, Scott and Zane that is in bed. And I'm going to do one load of laundry tonight. Yeah, and just stay caught up because I hate having tons of laundry to do. Many of you were asking about like where I find these. I found a lot of these over the door hooks or organizers at Walmart, but I also found quite a few on Amazon. I even took one on our cruise that held a lot of our stuff and kept it really organized within our little room. So, you know, they come in handy for so many things. And this room, I really don't mind it being here. Everybody can see it and they can get to it. And yeah, it's just super handy. But super fun night, laundry. Tonight's late night snack is a corn dog. Yum. That looks super yummy. And I'm going to eat this while I wait on the laundry to get done. Guess who's here, and look who's getting along today. Yay! We are here at Art's house, and the boys are loving the trampoline. And we got Cooper, Mako. Yeah, you got a doggy to play with, and we're gonna go swimming in just a few minutes at the lake. What are you barking at, Mako? It's nice that our dogs get along too, ain't it? It's nice. It's nice. That's Brittany's car. Art already bought that for her.
Don't make her look less skinny than.
Yeah. He looks a lot older too.
Look at Cooper. He's so fat.
He ain't fat. So I'm not a fat dog.
What?
He's not a fat dog.
Oh my God! Look at him. Hey, Kelly came on.
Who's
both
in Mako? I can't see Mako. Mako's out with your dad.
Mako, come.
That was cool. Gilbert's gonna go swimming in just a few minutes.
Hey, there we go. Show. See how much skinnier the dog is?
So he can't help it. He can't help it. So here he comes. Let's go. Let's go. We're at the park, you guys. This is Community Park. And Cooper's enjoying the water. Mm-hmm. He seems just to be enjoying the water. Come on. I love seeing these two get along. Cooper's over there choking on a stick. He's so enjoyed this water today. At least they're getting along today, you guys. They're doing a great job. And get the stick for the dog. So we are home from my ex-husband's, and I was going to give this guy a bath, but he is out. That's where he originally laid down. He hasn't gotten up. He's got his little eyes moving a little bit, but he is wore out. That swimming did him good. He enjoyed it. He didn't want to come out of the water. Everybody was like oohing and gooing over him whenever they'd walk past. So I'm going to let him be and let him take a bath tomorrow. He's not going to be in any of the beds. And I think he will, I think he'll be comfortable just getting a good night's sleep. He didn't even eat dinner, which is kind of different too, but I think it's just because he's exhausted. Hey everybody, so it is Thursday, about 10 p.m., and I just got out of the shower, and I wanted to talk to you guys for a few minutes. I don't think I've vlogged that much this week. It's been rather quiet. You know, there's no school going on. Zane's here, and he's just a quiet kid to begin with, and you know, obviously Scott's working, and so, I've had to go back. I haven't, like, looked at any of the footage yet, none. But, I wanted to talk to you guys about a couple different things. So did you guys already see, I guess you did, the footage of Jackson and Zane? They were getting along so well today, and, you know, both have been relatively bored, because Zane's here. Not too many friends yet in the neighborhood, but he's getting there. He's doing better. And Jackson said his dad's, and his dad's working, and, you know, he's kind of alone. And I think they both have, like, a lot of pinned-up energy and a lot of, you know, time that they have on their hands. So I think both of them kind of got to the stage where they were good and bored, and that was good. Because they have had their little spats. And, you know, I read all of your comments, and I always read every single comment. I might not be able to reply to every single one, but I always read them, always. And so, you know, I read, you know, many of you thought that I should just force the kids to be together. Many of you also said let them, you know, figure it out on their own, which I really try to do. Because I don't want to break up every single fight the kids get into. I'd be doing nothing else but, you know, breaking up sibling rivalry kind of things. But, you know, I had a talk, like, you know, I just want to be so careful what I say, but whatever. I'm just going to throw it out there. Like, when you ask Brittany to describe her brother, she would say, annoying, gets on my nerves, brat. If you asked Zane what he thought of Jackson, he would say annoying. If you asked Jackson he would say about his brother Zane, he would use a negative term. And so I had a talk first with Zane because he was here, you know, obviously. Brittany was still in Florida, and or she still is in Florida, and hold on. So I had a talk with Zane first about, let's try to use different words to describe our brothers and sisters. And then I went to Brittany on the phone, and I'm like, Brittany, Can we please figure out other words, kind words, that we can describe your brother, brothers? And then I went to Jackson, and I'm like, Jackson, can we please find better words to use to describe your brother and sister? And so all of them are on the same page. So, because if they keep saying Jackson's annoying, or, you know, they keep up saying that Brittany's a brat or Zane's sensitive, then that's never going to be able to change for any of the kids. So let's take away those stigmas, if you will, on all the kids and replace those with more loving, caring words. So we started there. And then Jackson had soccer practice on Wednesday, and he didn't want me at the first one. He was nervous, and I didn't go to it, and I was pretty disappointed, to be honest. But when Jackson came home, we had a talk on the phone about why, you know, he was nervous and everything. And, you know, you guys, Jackson and Zane both love YouTube more than Brittany. They watch pretty much all of my videos. They read the comments. And Jackson is honestly scared that if I show him messing up in any kind of way in soccer, you guys, well, like, 99% of you guys, 99.9% of you guys are amazing. One little bit of people, you know, are negative and talk crap, say, you know, different things, and Jackson's read some of that. And, you know, I might tease him about a haircut or something, but I think it's different coming from strangers. And, you know, they have made fun of the way he talks and said that we didn't get him speech therapy. We got him speech therapy when he was young. In middle school, they said he didn't need it anymore. And, you know, Scott and I were like, what? His dad really doesn't feel like he needs it. He's gotten a lot better. I mean, a lot. Brittany, growing up, was the only one that could understand him. Art couldn't. I couldn't. My grandparents couldn't. My mom couldn't. But Brittany understood him, like, completely. So, she helped us out a lot, you know, as he started talking. But he is scared. And so, before I talk about Jackson and Zane and today and all that, I do want to say this. You know, I really don't want to disable comments, but if I start seeing comments by people that I don't... Well, I was going to say people I don't recognize, because many of you are people I recognize. You know, you comment a lot in videos. But if I start seeing comments about it, I'm going to disable them. I'm going to be done. You know, Jackson has never really been athletic. He's just not. But he wants to be. He really wants to be. He's waited forever to be able to play soccer. Like, you know, we were really hoping he would get into a school activity, but soccer is not offered at his school, at his old school or his new school. So, he's definitely ready. And this is the first year. Like, he wasn't ready last year to just go play soccer, or we would have put him in it. I've been waiting so long for him to want to do something other than hunting or fishing. So, he's scared that if I film him, and he messes up with the ball, that some of you guys are going to make fun of him. And it just broke my heart. You know, we had a wonderful day, and then we had a wonderful time at Art's house. We took Cooper, let him go swimming, and it was just, you know, a really nice time. I'm trying to debate how much I'm showing the kids, or, you know, how much I'm showing Jackson, or how much I'm showing Brittany, or Zane, or Scott. Because, obviously, people are going to talk about them as well. But Brittany really don't mind being on camera as much. She looks a little snooty sometimes. But, you know, she's a 14-year-old girl who's trying to find her way. And it's okay. She's allowed to have an attitude every once in a while. I don't care. But It was really, really nice, like, seeing them play together and ride bikes and jump on trampolines. And, you know, I love every one of those kids, and they are all different and unique in their own ways. And I don't know, you guys. I just don't want people being mean to him. And, you know, on, like, the hate sites and stuff, Jackson does have, like, a little fan group. And it's kind of cute. And I don't think they are really going to talk about him not doing well. And I really don't worry about him and those kind of sites, because he hasn't talked to me about them. You know, he knows some of them are out there, but he is more concerned about the comments on my videos, because that's what he watches. So, you know, you guys, most of you are amazing, wonderful people. But if you're like the 1% that's not, please don't spoil it for everyone else. There's nothing anybody can do that will change the fact that I love all my kids. And Jackson has been my baby from the beginning. Like, he was so tiny. Stop, I'm not letting you out for a minute. He was so tiny. I probably didn't help with babying him so much, and I get it. And I think his dad is helping him grow up a little bit, because he's doing his own laundry. He's sweeping the floor. He's doing more. And, you know, my ex-husband's way of parenting is survival of the fittest. Is that how you say it? Like, you know, you need to, like be able to do some stuff. So, you know, it did help mature Brittany up. I thought she did too much at his house, like, in terms of, you know, laundry and stuff like that. But it also taught her how to be a little more independent. And we've tried to teach that to our kids from an early age. But I'm the one who babies them. It's just the way it goes. And I wasn't doing Jackson, Zane, or Brittany any favors by babying them. So I'm proud of my ex-husband for doing a good job with them. You know, we don't always agree, but I doubt you'll see him on video. He's like, don't show me, don't show me, don't show me. And, you know, he really just wants the kids happy too. And I think for him it was hard, you know, when Brittany moved out and moved in with me. And I just feel like each kid needed the other parent more than one they hadn't had that much time with here recently. So, you know, I feel like it's best. I feel like Brittany is happy. Nope. I feel like Brittany is super happy. I feel like Jackson is happy. I feel like Zane is happy. And that's what matters. That's what truly matters. So, you know, if you guys really are nice subscribers, say something nice every once in a while about Jackson. Obviously, he's super sensitive to the comments. And if I see a bunch of bad comments about any of my kids, I'm just going to start disabling them. I do delete them, but sometimes I don't delete them fast enough. And, you know, they're up for a half hour and people can see them. And, you know, I don't care who hates me. That's always going to be the way it goes. I didn't get to my 40th birthday without making some enemies. I mean, I'm serious. I made a list. I almost Instagrammed it because, let's just get up and let that cat out. I almost Instagrammed it because, you know, there's a few people that think I'm mad a lot. Well, the people on that list, and there's actually 13, so you guys know, who I don't like are people that I don't like for a reason. Like, and my ex-husband ain't on that. You know, there's a cousin on it. And, you know, there's a few people on it, but I'm not mad all the time. And I try to be myself. I try to show you guys that you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to get on camera and be fake. You can be yourself. If someone thinks I'm trashy, then let them think it. Let them say it. Let them feel the way they feel. I respect it. Who cares? But I draw the line at other people being mean to my kids. If I want to make fun of Jackson in a loving kind of way, that is my son. I can do that. But I'll be damned if I'm going to let other people talk about him. I'm just not going to do it. And that goes for Brittany, Zane, Laura, the whole bunch. You know, and I don't know what else to say except I love them and I'm proud of them and I can't wait to show you Jackson in soccer And I can't wait to share with you Zane in football and Brittany in cheerleading. And it's also been said that Brittany's my favorite. Well, they got that shit all wrong. I don't really have favorites among the kids. I love them individually and together all the same. Like, you got to parent each kid different, at least in my house you do. And I do think the girls are funner, at least at this point. But they are amazing. And, you know, I really think that me sharing different parts of their lives is, number one, to document it for us, and number two, to, you know, share with you guys a little bit of our life. And I have wonderful kids, and it just really bothered me to hear Jackson say, I'm scared people are going to make fun of me if I mess up. You know, the kids aren't going to be perfect in sports. Like, I don't have perfect kids. I have amazing kids, beautiful kids, smart kids, but they're not perfect, and they're not all like super athletic. They're doing their best, and I don't know, I just wanted to get on here and say that. So it bothered me. It just really bothered me. And I'm like, well, most of the people on YouTube support you, they love you, and you know, you have a fan club. And Jackson's like, I'm just scared they'll make fun of me. So, you know, I'm going to do my best not to show him messing up. But that's part of learning too. Especially even when you lose games, there's a lot to be learned from losing a game, a sports match of any kind. And I think personally the lesson goes in losing instead of winning. You know, I mean, there's not a whole lot of lessons in winning, but there's a lot more in losing. So, you know, Zane's like a poor loser, and that's the truth. If I beat him bowling, he'd get so mad. And if Scott beat him on Call of Duty, he would get so angry with him. You know, we're working on good sportsmanship as well as manners and kindness. And, you know, I don't mind the kids teasing each other a little bit. I don't mind that at all. But I still want them to, you know, try to respect each other a little bit more. And that worked out beautifully today. They had a wonderful time. And yeah, Scott is laid up in the living room. He is sick. He has the flu. Hopefully we'll get him feeling better. He didn't make the Try the World video with me yet. We need to make it. But he, like, thinks he's got strep throat. And I don't know how your men are, ladies, but when mine thinks he's, when mine's sick, he thinks he's dying. I mean, I have to do the laundry and still cook and do all this stuff when I have the flu, and my husband is, like, totally the opposite. When he's sick, the whole world stops, and he sleeps, which is good. So I loaded him up with Theraflu and, like, some daytime medicine, even though it's 10, but that's all I really had on hand. And he is crashed out. So some of you guys, I think, are wondering where he's at a little bit more. I just don't want to show him all the time. He didn't ask to be on YouTube. The kids really didn't ask. And so, I mean, I don't want to show him all the time. It's my channel. It's not his. And I'll show him when I feel like it. But he is still alive and well. And Brittany is still alive and well. And by the way, you guys, I had a couple comments on Facebook which did get deleted, and a lot of people say, you didn't have those comments, I didn't see them. That's because I happened to delete them before you did see them. But I put Brittany, I put a video of Brittany on the beach doing a backflip in her bikini. Did I question whether I should put it up there or not? Yes. I asked Brittany, no problem out of her. I kind of asked around what others would think. My best friends, like, I posted pictures of my daughter in her swimsuit. And the truth is, you guys, they can take pictures of your clothed kids and turn them into what they want. I can't stop a dirty old man from looking at some pictures halfway across the United States. I can't stop that. They can do that with clothed pictures. I mean, you know, and in a way, you know, if you have a sexual thought about my 14-year-old daughter, then you got some pretty messed up thoughts. And there is an alarm system on this house. Many of you don't know about it. It came through, I know it's crazy, it came through the phone company. I can't believe it, but it did. And there's some cameras out in front of the house. And we have the Cooper, and he barks like crazy. And I'm not too worried about my home not being safe. I don't care if you have my address. If you come on over, we'll be nice to you, most people. But, you know, if you're here to harm us or something, you're probably going to be surprised at what comes at you. But if you're a dirty old pervert, you're gonna look at that sexually. If you're a mom with teenagers, maybe you're going to look at it like just a mom. Like, I did question it. I did. I'm not going to lie. I can't worry about that every single second of the day. I can't. She sent me another amazing picture in her little bikini with Kinsey, and I didn't post it because I might still, but I don't know. I don't want people like talking negative and thinking I'm just sexualizing my kids. I don't look at Brittany in a sexual way, in a two-piece, but she's also not got like a ton of cleavage. She's not wearing thongs. She's just a girl, and I didn't see anything dirty in that picture or in that video. And if somebody did, then that's their problem, not mine and not Brittany's, and that doesn't fall on Brittany's shoulders, and it certainly don't fall on mine, because, you know, these are amazing girls, and they are covered up in the parts that are most important to be covered up in. And like I said, if some dirty old pervert's looking at that picture, what can I really do about it? Nothing. They could look at her clothes pictures and be dirty old men. I'm not as concerned as some would be on that, but God knows if something did happen, I would cut YouTube out. I don't care. I mean, I love talking to you guys, but if I see any kind of safety concerns with my kids, I'll cut it out. I don't care. The money is just like this much. I just use it just to play with, and I really just don't, I would cut YouTube out if I thought it was a danger to my children, and I don't. And not every single person follows on Instagram. So, you know, I don't know. I'm just blabbing on. I haven't talked to you guys in a bit. I missed you. And I just wanted to kind of fill you in what was going on in my head tonight. My kids, you know, are the world to me. And my best friend said to me, she said, you know, you were still keeping up with Brittany through FaceTime and emails and everything else, and lots of interaction, like tons, more than probably parents that live with their kids, because I was trying to make up for not being here. And she's like, I just don't think you realized how much you missed your daughter. And she's right. I truly missed her, and I will never be away from my kids again. It won't happen. So I'm happy we're all here together. I'm still happy with my home. I'm still happy with my neighborhood, which I love. I'm in a good spot, you guys. I really am. I might get mad at my husband sometimes, but that's nothing. I don't know. I feel blessed. And I just wanted to come on here, tell you what I was thinking, what I was feeling. I'm going to relax. I'm going to hang out, try to look at some of the footage, see where we're at, you know, footage-wise, and I will see you guys tomorrow morning. Alrighty? Bye. Look at the little hedgehog. I came in here and he, like, froze right on his wheel. Hello. There's our kitty cat. There's Willow. Let it wait for him to move. If I turn off the light, he will probably start running on his wheel again. He's cute. He's gonna go in his little tube, I bet. That's cute. In he goes. Jackson made that for him. And he uses it all the time. Cupcake got groomed up today. She always looks like she's mad. Kitty, 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 kitty. The other one's probably heard me call her. She got groomed up today. She mats more than any of the other cats, and it's just so hard to keep her perfectly groomed. She sees something, like a little fly or something. Cupcake! She's like, yeah, no. No. I hope you guys are having a wonderful Tuesday. I am tired. It's a little after midnight, and I think I'm going to get ready to take a shower and go to bed. Amazing, and I just got done selling everything now that I want. Yum. Here is our dinner. Look at that. Mine's in the middle. Scott's are on this side. And I got a soup and salad coming, and plum wine and a vodka tonic. Is that right? Right. Okay. Dinner time. So, I know it's kind of hard to see you guys, but we are catching fireflies, and that's something the kids love doing. Scott's out there with them. I guess you can't really see it, but there they go. A little bit. No. They're trying to get them, though. They were just lighting it up, and now they're stopped. I guess they have to be patient. You guys, look. Now, we were up. Scott and I were up to like after 3 a.m. last night, so I slept in a little bit. It is noon. He left me flowers. He got a new coffee pot and told me he's playing golf. And our old coffee pot was messed up, so he went and got this one. I'm amazed. I just wanted to share it. And him and Zane are playing golf, and he got us a new coffee pot. Our other coffee pot was, and some flowers. Our other coffee pot was just not working. The red one. So he got this Mr. Coffee. And I don't know that much about it, but he saved it. And here's the box. Like, I called him from bed and I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, go in the kitchen, go in the kitchen. I'm in the kitchen, and he's not in the kitchen, but, yeah, that's so sweet. That's nice. Let's hope the coffee tastes amazing. So, Scott and I and Zane are going out with Trina and her husband for a birthday dinner. I am in this really pretty flowy skirt. I have a lot of long skirts that I wear in, summer, spring, summer, and fall, and it just feels good getting it out. I don't have a full-length mirror anywhere close, or I would show you, but I just got just like a regular cotton tee on just because it's comfortable. But yeah, I love it, and I'm so happy to have it back out. We are here having a birthday dinner. There's Zane training.
So we stopped in.
Scott's over here. And we are figuring out our dinner. The ceiling has all the wine bottles.
Yes. Chiropractor?
So we are in the bathroom, Mrs. Trina and I. So cute in here. They got this bra. They have all these pictures on the walls. It's really cute. So we had a wonderful dinner and we are all heading home. We're full. We got chocolate cake to go. And I'm ready, so yay, time to relax. Bye. So we are home from dinner. Scott's out here. And we're just kind of playing with Cooper. And our cats just love coming out in this. Like, there's Gabby, there's Willow. Where's Cupcake? She was right around here somewhere. Cupcake. I don't know where she went.
Good job.
She's around here. She's the nervous one. Cupcake didn't come out, did she? Okay, well, she'll be out. I just seen her a couple minutes ago, but she hides a lot. But it's a beautiful night here, you guys. We had a lovely dinner. Did you enjoy dinner?
Yes, I did. Very much so.
Yeah, it was nice. And, Scott.
What?
And, yeah, it was lovely, so.
Mom and doggy's gotta have fun, too.
He's still handling his dog food, even though my mom's convinced there's a better dog food and wants me to switch it again. So I might, I mean, I don't know. She's convinced it's got lower fat, it's a better diet dog food, and I don't know. You think we should switch it again?
I think you should talk to the vet.
Yeah.
Not to the mom? Not to the mom. Talk to the vet. Although she knows a lot.
She does do. Animals. She's training dogs now.
Is she?
Yep.
I know she had the pedigree for a while, so I know she does a lot, but...
He's over here eating grass, which is something he always does. I'm trying to find Cupcake. I don't know where she went. There she is. She's right behind the door. Hi. Hi. Oh, there she goes. That's Cupcake. Hi. There's Romeo. Hi, Cooper.
All right, drop it. Drop it. Cover some ground.
Yeah. Romeo's all the way out in the yard. It's so weird.
All the way across after Cooper.
Yeah.
Come here, Romeo, come on.
Scott left me a really sweet note this morning. Coffee pot and flowers. That was super nice. I posted a picture on Instagram, you guys. It's a Mr. Coffee. And our other one just stopped like working. And Scott said it was like hard to decide on coffee pots, was it?
There were like 50 of them.
I know. That's the
that
one I want is like $3,000.
$200. I mean, yeah. You know, I didn't know what to get, so I kind of split the difference. So.
Yeah, it's nice. As long as it works and it made good coffee today.
You might want to get her.
Yeah, she's the one that we worry about, Willow. I just ran a Cupcake back in the house. Where is she?
Yeah.
There she is. She's at the water.
Let's go.
She can jump at that fence. That's the only reason Willow can jump from the floor to the top of the refrigerator. So she has to stay on the patio. She can be gone. But he just is at home. He meows at the door every day now. Yeah. And so the fence is great as long as they can't really get out. But it worries me. We always have to check and make sure it's like locked up on each side. Or we'll be hunting for some cats. Hey everybody. It is Sunday here. So... I woke up today a little bit late again. Scott and I have had a late weekend. Like, we went to bed so late the past couple nights. I woke up to this, and it's so heartbreaking. It's going to weigh heavy on my heart all day. It's just sad. And, yeah, it's just not the way I wanted to start the day. And I'm sure it's not how they really wanted to end their life, you know? It's just mind-boggling to me. I don't really know what to say about it, except all of our prayers are going to them this morning. So I'm going to get some coffee out of that new coffee pot and start my day. Hey, everybody. So it is later in the afternoon. It's actually like 5:30 p.m., and I'm going to pick up Brittany from Kenzie's house. So they made it safely back and I couldn't be more grateful. And I'm happy to be going and getting her. So that's what I'm doing right now. So I made breakfast for dinner tonight and I just got done cleaning up the kitchen, which I'm totally happy about. So now I can go like relax with Scott and watch some TV. But everything's done, dishes are done, and I'm so happy that Brittany is coming home so she can get back to her chore of emptying out that dishwasher. But I never like to wake up to a dirty kitchen. I mean, that's just one of the ways to be, have a depressing day, to wake up to a mess. And so I just don't want to do that. I don't do that. There's some nights that, you know, if I'm sick or something, but 90% of the time, probably 99.9% of the time, I like a clean kitchen. I am going to throw that coffee pot out tomorrow, though. But yeah, it just feels good to have everything cleaned up and ready for morning. Hey, everybody. It is Sunday night here, and I wanted to say goodnight to you guys. I am really tired. I didn't vlog that much today. I just didn't feel that well. Scott and I both have been feeling pretty under the weather. It's like there's a bug or something. I don't know. But, you know, it was a hard day with everything going on the news with the big mass shooting in Orlando. So, you know, our heart and prayers go out to all those affected, all the families, all the victims. It's like tragic and super sad. I went and picked Brittany up today. She came home, went straight to bed. Straight to bed. And so you didn't see anything of her, see any footage of her tonight because she crashed out on us. And yeah, so tomorrow I've got to just work around the house. I have a blog post I want to get written. I just have stuff I need to do my normal Monday, and I hope you guys have a beautiful and blessed week. Thank you for watching this vlog. If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to get subscribed, and I will see you with a fresh new week. I'm so happy about it. But now I'm ready for bed, and I am calling it a night. So, sweet dreams. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.